Hallo julle, welkom by sessie 3, bladsy 56, graad 12, isometriese tekeninge. Nou, die vorige sessies, as jy dit nog nie gekyk het nie, gaan asseblief gaan kyk dit, die eerste en die tweede videoetjies. Guys, if you haven't seen the previous two videos on this drawing, please go and watch that. I cover third angle orthographic projection, I cover how to interpret the drawing, as well as the basics of isometric in grade 12, which is basically the angled lines and then of course the circles. Now guys, what I'm going to focus on today is I'm going to focus on two things. I'm going to quickly look at the circle, how to draw the circle with two depths. The second thing that I'm going to look at is how to get the back part of this drawing, which you will see is slightly more to the side there. And I'm going to help you guys to figure that out. So I'm going to be doing this lesson in both English and Afrikaans to make it easy for everybody to understand what I'm teaching. Guys, there's one thing that I've picked up on this memo. You guys will see that there's a vertical line going down here. I'll just double check this on the memo a little bit later just to make sure. So it's actually what it is, you guys will see. I see it now. This is that line over there and it's right here. So it seems to be running straight down, but you guys will pick up that if you look at any lines in an isometric drawing which are drawn at 45 degrees, in other words, on this triangle, you guys will see that is clearly a 45 degree angle that we see there. It always works out on an isometric drawing on a straight line most of the time. So you guys will see this is actually that angled line coming towards you on a flat surface. So this is actually a flat surface. This surface is the surface that you are seeing over there. So a bit of a catch when you look at it. At first it almost got the better of me as well. But if you guys look at it very clearly and able, you will be able to see that that is actually the surface that you see over there. This is of course the top view and the front view of the drawing. Okay guys, but we're going to focus on that a little bit later. First of all, I'm going to look at the how to draw the isometric circle. Now, first of all, in this drawing, you guys will see that there is a center point, which is of importance here. It's 50 millimeters from the side of the drawing. It's also 32 up. So if you go 32 up, which is that point there, you have a 30 degree line running through there, and you measure from the side of the drawing there, 50 millimeters, you'll find the center point. Now, the center point is that same center point that you have over there. Now, this doesn't matter if you are drawing a full circle, half a circle, a quarter of a circle, the construction will stay the same. There are some shortcuts which I will get to a little bit later, which you could use. But for now, let's look at the full method. So you've got that center point over there, which you got by measuring to get that point. They tell you that its diameter, that circle with a line through, means diameter 42, which means it's from the one side to the other side. That, of course, means that you'll have to divide it by 2 to give you a 21 millimeter radius. So if you guys have a look here, you'll see that it's 21 millimeters from there to there. Now, the best way to do this is basically to either take a compass, I love doing that, place it there in the middle, mark it off yourself, 21, 21, 21, 21. Now, if you don't have a proper compass, then it's better to do this by measuring. But guys, make sure that you are measuring really accurately. So 21, 21, 21, and 21. Then you can simply go, and I'm going to put my T-square on my board. I'm going to once again double check that it is in fact on my two lines that I had. Even though I might have a double lock system board, this could give you the same problem. So make sure that it's on the line there, and you guys will see now I can simply take that line. I can draw a construction line for myself. I can draw a construction line at the top because I've already measured it out. I'm going to have a line over there and I'm going to have a line over here. So guys, in that box, isometric circles can be done on three sides of a drawing. It can be done on this side, it can be done on that side, and of course it can be done on the top. The method stays exactly the same. So what you need to do is you need to find the obtuse angle. Obtuse angles are angles bigger than 90 degrees. Very easy to find them. If you look at 90 degrees, that is a 90 degree angle. So if something is obviously bigger than 90, it's obtuse angle. Now in this drawing, I'm going to mark the obtuse angles for you. It's the one over here and the one at the top there. Okay, the other ones are the two acute angles. In Afrikaans, so ons dit genoem die stomphoeke. En dit is die stomphoeke wat ek gebruik om basies my grootste deel van my constructie mee te doen. Wat jy dan doen is, daar is meer as een methode hier. Jy sal sien verskillende boeke gebruik verskillende methodes. Ek is lief vir hierdie ene. Van die stomphoek trek jy lyn tot aan die bokant van jou vertikale sentelyn. En jylle sal sien, wel nie toevallig nie, dit behoort uit te werk op 'n 60 grade lyn. So, as jy kyk na hierdie lyn, jy sien die hoek daar is vorm vir jou 'n 60 grade lyn vanaf die horizontale lynkie wat jy daar sien. Die volgende is letterlik 'n horizontale lyn. Hy hardloop tot in die middel aan die ander kant. So, dit gee vir jou so 'n tipe van 'n V, wat jy tot in die bokant trek, en tot wat jy aan die ander kant trek. Nou, jy kan precies dieselfde herhaal uit die ander stomphoek naar dieselfde punte toe, met ander woorde na die horizontale asse punt toe en na die vertikale as onderse punt toe. Ek is baie lief om eenvoudig in plaas van twee lyne slegs een lyn te trek en dit sal jy kry deur die twee skerphoeke te verbind. Dit hardloop gewoonlik deur die middelpunt van die tekening. Maak weer eens baie seker dat jy akkuraat na die punte toe trek. 'N halwe millimeter wat jy uit is op jou tekening, kan maak dat jou tekening nie gaan uitwerk nie. Goed, so luister, dit is so eenvoudig soos dit. Wat jy nou doen is, hy bestaan uit 4 klein sirkels. Jy het 2 groot sirkels en jy 2 kleiner sirkels. Baie maklik om te onthou. Die 2 klein sirkeltjies wat ek hier gaan intrek vir julle, daai sirkel daar, en hierdie sirkel hierso, kry ek waar die 2 lyne mekaar kruis. En op watter grootte maak jy jou passer oop, jy maak het letterlik oop vanaf daai punt tot daai punt. Dit is so eenvoudig soos dit. Ek gaan vinnig die video gou net stop.